I'm Kelly Warner. As we've learned more and more about COVID-19 over the last 6 months, the list of symptoms linked to the virus has expanded. And since coronavirus shares many of the same symptoms with other illnesses, doctors say no worry is too small to reach out to your pediatrician.
At Eugene Pediatric Associates, pediatricians field questions daily from parents concerned about coronavirus.
The challenge with COVID is it is a viral syndrome, and viral syndromes by definition are nonspecific.
Dr. Lauren A. Braun is a pediatric infectious disease expert. She says how COVID-19 manifests in children and adults can vary significantly, with symptoms ranging from fevers and chills to shortness of breath and fatigue, to headache, muscle ache, sore throat, and even a loss of taste and smell. Since many of those symptoms are also symptoms of other illnesses, her advice to parents is this.
If your child has any manifestations of illness, that's important not to send them back to school, not to put them in daycare. Those children need to stay home and stay isolated. Call your healthcare provider. Your pediatrician or your medical provider can tell you how to get that child tested in a safe way. The test is a swab that goes in the back of the nose, deep into the nose and the nasopharynx, but it's not harmful. It's not a painful test. It feels funny to have something going in your nose, but it's the best test collection is to get those samples from the back of the nose.
Test results are typically available within 72 hours, and families are advised to isolate or quarantine as needed. Since some children and even adults with COVID may be asymptomatic, doctors stress the importance of taking steps to reduce the potential spread of the virus, including wearing face masks in public spaces, practicing social distancing, and making good hand hygiene a regular habit.
The more that we want to support small business, the more that we want to support schools, the more that we want to support, you know, all of our community, that means the more we should be getting tested, doing the right things with isolation and quarantine, wearing our masks, doing all those things, because we are not going to be able to stay reopened unless we do those things.
Isolation and quarantine are two terms that are often confused. It's important to know the difference as well as the circumstances when one or the other may be recommended for you or a family member. Learn the specifics and get more information about COVID testing at eugenepeds.com/healthykids. I'm Kelly Warner.